like Laura Presley, who speak the truth. But the present city council, God love them, they're a bunch of cowards. And I say this with unbelievable respect. There's people like, you know, there's some good people down there, but you show them this information and you say, whose side are
you
on?
The FDA said quit using fluoride as a pesticide 2 years ago, Wall Street Journal.
You see it on toothpaste. It says if you swallow this stuff, go to the doctor. I mean,
it's like the chemtrails.
It's
hiding in plain view. But getting back to consciousness and, yes, and reality, I interrupted you with that.
But the point is that for every one of these beings who are afraid of looking at the truth, and we all know those people, they're members of our family, they go to our churches, that we see them at the coffee shop. Every single day, more and more and more people are waking up. They're listening to your show. They're coming to groups like the Circle of Intention. They're learning about life. They're reading good books. They're talking to other people. And we're coming together. And all, wherever I go, every day I have this conversation. You know, Alex, the number of people who come up to me and say, hey, I've read your book, or I've seen your movie, or I've seen you on Alex Jones, and then they just want to talk. It is so, it keeps my heart warm.
Let me ask you a question. Why do you think you're still alive and myself still alive? People ask that question. They don't want to do a highlight over what we've said. They don't want to put exclamation points behind what we've said. They don't want to create martyrs. But at the same time, they just want to assassinate our names. But I think a lot, and I know a lot of people in the system, they're scared as well. We have more allies than we know.
Oh, absolutely.
I mean, it's not the government, folks. It's not even the average company. It's select groups that know how to manipulate people. We're all in this together. But why do you think we're still alive?
Well, thank God. I mean, first of all, I have a very, very strong belief in the Creator and the goodness of the Creator,
That's right. We're protected,
and I do believe that we are protected. And I'm not trying to go, you know, hardcore religious or anything like, but I do believe that we are protected. I also believe that within the system there are good people who are realize, you know, they know we're good people. They know that we're here to protect our country, to make our country better, to make our world a safer, more beautiful place, because they have children, they have grandchildren themselves, and they can see that if we continue down this primrose path, we're not talking about just corporate fascism around the world. We're talking about perhaps the extermination of large numbers of people on this planet.
That's the set goal.
Absolutely it is. Absolutely it is. And when Ted, you know, and they're really talking, because it's all about power, but it's not going to happen.
You've been in a lot of elite circles, and I've run into some in my years, and so has my dad. How often when you're at a cocktail party years ago or playing golf with, you know, billionaires, whatever, I know you have, do they bring up, we've got to get rid of the public, we've got to reduce the population? Because I know that's the cocktail talk in these groups.
Well, I used to hear that 20, 25 years ago. I don't hear that so much anymore. Occasionally I hear that, but I think more people, first of all, they know more about who I am, and so they watch their conversation a lot more. It's also because I don't hang out with those people as much as I, you know, I just choose my friends different. I like being around more like-minded people. But you know what's really incredible is like 15 or 20 years ago, these people wouldn't talk to me, and now they want to play tennis, or they want to play golf, or they want to come over, and more people are...
In the beginning, a patriot's a scarce man, hated, feared, and scorned. In time, when his cause succeeds, the timid join him, because then it costs nothing to be a patriot, Mark Twain. So you've gone full circle, being ostracized, and now they're begging you to come around.
Yeah, and you carry a sharper knife than I do, because you're at it day after day after day after day after day, and I choose my words a little bit more softly, but you and I are saying the same things. But more and more people, because we all realize it's all based upon the pyramid. And most of the people who are part of the power elite, who are in the pyramid, they don't understand the big picture. But because the grass grows from the roots and the grass is coming up, and they're starting to realize that they're...
I was about to say, some of the most controlled are at the last third of the pyramid.
Absolutely.
Not at the very top. They know what's going on at the top. But right up, right near it are some of the most controlled, compartmentalized people. And that's when I know my job is to shake people awake so they can then be decompartmentalized. Not to hear what I have to say. You wake up and take the red pill, baby. baby. You can't be told about the Matrix. You got to see it.
You've got to see it. But these people are waking up because they realize the folks higher up, they don't care about them. There is no loyalty in this group of what we call the Illuminati.
Look at the VA.
We've been looking at the VA for 20 years. I mean, you know, you and I both realize how inefficient it is. It's just totally, completely inefficient. And just like you talk about Obama, I mean, Obamacare is sick care. It is, all you have to do is follow the money. Look at the stocks of the insurance companies that
They exploded.
The value of the stocks that deal with Obamacare, their valuations have exploded.
Just and then you the buy into the sin and buy stock and make money off the eugenics and the death panels.
But there's a better way, and that's what...
I want to talk about solutions in two more segments, Ed and Dinesh D'Souza. And listen, I know you're about to leave the country again, this time for South America. You've got to go in there and do 20 minutes for the nightly news or as long as you want, uninterrupted.
Okay, great.
George, it's so good to see my friend George Humphrey here. And we're going to give out websites, anything else you want to plug when we come back. Stay with us. A good friend of mine, you know, he said his books and videos are mainly out of print if you can find them. He's just, you know, busy doing other research right now. But, I mean, plug some of them if folks want to find them on eBay or other places.
Well, my first booklet was called Common Sense, An Introduction to the
Danger. The book on tape was world class.
Yeah.
Give me a copy of that. I'll put it on prisonplanet.tv.
Okay, I've still got some of those tapes there. So and the second one was Uncommon Sense, Your Choice, the Red Pill, Blue Pill or the Red Pill. And then I wrote one of the very first books about 9/11 called 9/11, The Great Illusion. And I made one of the first full-length documentaries about 9/11, 9/11, The Great Illusion, that Alex has done a great job selling. And it's, you know what? I looked at it the other day, and I made it 10 years ago, and it's still, you know, one of the better, you know, films out there. I mean, 9/11 is a slam. Anybody who doesn't understand 9/11 is not paying attention.
And it shows they'll do incredible hoaxes, and we're not saying the whole government, criminal networks.
Right.
Just like they got, but now they get caught, George. They got caught launching chemical attacks to blame it on Syria, and it even came out in the BBC. It was staged.
Of course.
I mean, but used to, that was like, oh, our government has no connection to Al-Qaeda, you traitor.
Well, it was all about a pipeline. I mean, you know, basically what it was is that the Rothschild forces wanted another pipeline so that Russia didn't have the only gas line going in.
Same reason they're going into Ukraine right now. It's the same story.
Exactly. And friends, always follow the money. And, you know, what you have right now is the Rothschild interest of Western Europe versus Putin. And even though, and I'm not supporting Putin because he's a gangster, but he's a really smart gangster. And if you ever listen to what he has to say, a lot of what he has to say.
Well, he put a guy on national TV and they've asked me on the guy's show and I just didn't do it. That they say is the Alex Jones of Russia. He has the big state where he runs the state-run media now.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
They basically say don't take the shots. They're putting stuff in them. Mm-hmm. It's eugenics. They pay people to have kids. I mean, the Russians have really, I think, turned a corner. I'm not saying it's not gangster run.
Oh, it is
gangster. But they want a large gangster force. And they're not trying to kill their own people. The Russians don't hate their own people anymore, and they realize the Soviet system was a globalist program.
And by the way, the Russians don't put fluoride in the water. God, the Chinese don't put fluoride in the water. The Eastern Europeans and many of the countries in Western Europe don't put fluoride in the water. And on and on and on and on and on. And even though Putin is a gangster, he's somewhat of a nationalist. And, you know, it's always important to listen to both sides of a story. Both sides of the story. And, you know, what we're fed in the predominant media, it just makes, you know, you and I have seen this. I mean, we know all the buzzwords. We realize it. And for 20 years, I've just kind of laughed at it because it's so transparent. But most people, it's amazing. They believe this stuff. They truly believe this
stuff. And now the elite go on CNN and MSNBC every week and go, we lie to the public.
Yeah.
Susan Rice came out and said, yeah, we lie, big deal. I mean, they now just say, Gibbs says, yeah, we lie to you. What is that?
Because they realize that the people are so, you know, you got to have courage. The home of the free and the land of the brave. Well, folks, the courage level, the vibration, the intensity of the American people has gone down so much. The apathy, the welfare, the all the things.
And that's why this show's been successful for all its warts.
Absolutely.
Is it changes the wavelength, gets people out of their doldrums. Do 5 more minutes before Dinesh D'Souza on Solutions. George Humphreys.
This is GCN, the Genesis Communications Radio Network.
A chemical spill contaminating the water supply in 9 West Virginia counties.
This year alone, over 300,000 people in West Virginia had their drinking water contaminated.
What are the health effects of having these drugs in our drinking water?
It's forced medical treatment without the consent of residents.
My friends, water filtration is one of the most basic actions you can take to protect you and your family from the harmful toxins and heavy metals in your tap water.
On average, the county says it sprays with glyphosate at least once a week.
Few filters cut out the glyphosate that is found in water supplies worldwide. Remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, hydrofluorosilicic acid, sodium hexafluorosilicate.
Fluoride, it is in tea, it's in coffee, it's in water, it's in bread, it's in toothpaste.
It is our responsibility to protect our families. The establishment's not going to do it. It's time to take action. It's time to filter our water. Visit InfoWarsStore.com and use promo code WATER to get 10% off their entire family of incredible products.